We'll see what we can do. We'll see what we can do a little bit later on. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, a Footy Show treat, because one of the great Australian actors of all time joins us. He's the 2004 Golden Globe winner for Best Actor in a TV Series, of course, Without a Trace, which you see 8:30 Wednesday on 9. The 2002 Emmy Award winner for his role in Frasier, 2001 AFI Award winner. Not only that, he's part owner of the Sydney Football Club and is the goalkeeper for the magnificently named Hollywood United. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mr. Anthony LaPaglia.
I am. I'm so excited today. I just cannot wait to get out there and see this game.
We've given a blurb on you. It reads, I'm like a complete drug addict when it comes to football. Obviously,
somebody
for a long,
added,
long time...
Somebody added when it comes to football.
Yeah. What does this mean to you today, to be here watching Australia take on Brazil?
It means an enormous amount. I mean, to me, as a football fanatic, tragic, as we call them in Australia, it's been... I remember the first time we were here in 74. I was a kid watching it on TV, and I didn't realize it would take us 31 years to get back here. And lose the accent? All right, mate, I'll lose the accent. All right. All right. It's occupational hazard, sorry. So I remember being a kid and watching it in 74. Watching all those great players, Pete Wilson, Ray Barts, all those guys. And Andy Abani, and, you know, all the players from that, you know, period to now have contributed. It's like, it feels like a collective thing to me. It's taken 30 years, you know, for us to get back here. And in our first game out against Japan, you know, we performed magnificently and actually won our first World Cup game ever.
Gary Lyon, Anthony, you speak with real emotion. You can see the real emotion in your voice here. We know obviously how much it means. Here we are coming together from all different codes. I mean, you would have been swimming up against the tide a fair bit back in Australia when perhaps soccer, as we call it, wasn't prominent. I mean...
No, it used to be called wogball. in 78, 79 when I played.
All that sort of stuff. Yeah. And a teen boy growing up in Australia. I mean, Now everyone's jumping on board. I mean, do you feel that vindicates your support of the code going a long way back?
I don't think it vindicates... I think that the market has always been there in Australia and the interest has always been there. But I think it was divided along ethnic lines. And with the new A-League... I think making it non-denominational has made it available to the entire country. So... I think in the past people felt like, you know, you had to be Croatian or you had to be Italian or you had to be... In order to go to those games. Since taking that out, I think it's helped the game grow.
Benefits on
Anthony. Richard Harris once said that he'd give up every film credit, every acting award he ever got, just to run out once for Ireland. Would you give up as much to run out for Australia in a World Cup?
Yes. If you give me the shirt now, and you can convince Mark Schwarzer not to play, I'll do it right now.
Yeah. Now, Anthony, I just got to ask you. You spoke about the game running along ethnic lines, and you're a proud Italian as well as Australian.
Yes.
Now, if we get through to the second round and we're playing the Italians,
well,
you're going to root
last
for.
Night, I don't think you may not have that concern. but if that does happen, Australia.
Could I ask you a really simple, basic question? You will say to me, I'm sure, that I should know this. How do we get into Group F with Brazil, Australia, Japan and Croatia? How do you get into that category?
They draw it out of a raffle.
Thank you, Anthony.
They draw it out.
Do they?
They draw it out of a raffle, and then I think there may be a little bit of... Oh, I don't know. I think they draw it out of a raffle.
Do you think I should have known that? That's pretty simple.
I'm always amazed at how they manage to keep, like, Argentina and, say, England...
Yes, this is my point.
Group. But I wonder...
Anthony, being an Italian, you wouldn't tell me that there's any rigging going on in soccer.
No.
Never.
Especially with what's going on in Italy right now.
Yeah, Juventus are having a hard time, there's no doubt about it. Before we go further, let's have a look at Anthony in action. This is a scene from this week's Without a Trace, 8:30 on Channel 9.
Sam and Danny found her at the hospital. The parking attendant said he heard a skirmish.
Was it with Claire?
Oh, she's denying everything.
So far.
Mm-hmm. Look, do you mind if I talk to her alone?
You want to or you need to?
A little bit of both.
You okay?
Not especially.
You gonna be okay in there?
I promise I won't hurt her.
Okay, I appreciate that.
Anthony, before we get back to the soccer, your career in the States has been absolutely fantastic. You had to fight the hard way, had to get the Brooklyn Voice going.
Yep.
I was over there for the screenings recently, and Anthony's photo is just all over the lot at Warner Brothers. Unbelievable there. It's just been a magnificent couple of years with you with this particular role.
Yeah, every now and then you need a bit of luck.
But you've taken your luck and run with it.
Yeah, well, you know. Yeah. When the advantage comes, when the opportunity arises, you have to grab it with both hands. And it's the same in acting as it is in football, as it is in anything. You hang around long enough, they get sick of you and they give you a job.
There we're... Thanks, Jack. Enjoy the day today, mate. You've done a fantastic job for Australian soccer, as has this man. He might be in Hollywood. He might have to have an American accent at times for his craft. But there's no doubt that he's put not only his support but his money behind the Sydney Football Club and everything with Australian soccer. Anthony, thank you very much for being our guest tonight, mate.
Thank you.
Anthony LaPaglia. And ladies and gentlemen...